Hi, I'm Alex Silverman, soccer reporter for Sports Business Journal, and I'm joined by the new president of Gotham FC, Mary Wittenberg. Mary, congratulations on the new job, and thank you for joining us today.
Thank you so much, Alex. I have a new first task to do, and that's to get you a Gotham scarf for your setup.
Yeah, I'll have to add that to the Zoom background going forward. You know, you've been in a wide variety of roles in the sports industry. Why was president of an NWSL club and specifically Gotham FC the right opportunity for you at this point in your career?
It's an amazing opportunity. I love transformational opportunities. I love the potential to have outsized impact. I'm a builder. I really like to take something from here to there with a great team. And I'm a champion, an advocate of the people I work with, and the chance to be on the team side and really cheer and support our team. Those are some of the things I love most about opportunities. And this is a really unique one at a time when the league is ascendant. The team is full of opportunity and has a big vision. And it's all here at home where we can really uniquely take advantage of being in the New York, New Jersey area.
Yeah. You know, you mentioned the transformation and the desire to grow the club. What are sort of your top priorities as you take over?
Well, everything centers around the player, the fan, the team, and the city and states that we live in. The vision, like we really, this can be, the tri-state area can be the global capital of women's soccer. Like the roots of soccer here, the potential to build on that is massive. I think our early steps are first be really loved in, you know, a New York, New Jersey, uniquely New York, New Jersey pro team that people really feel a part of. So those are like the bigger picture that we start with, and then the early steps all lead to that. But a year ago, our team very much focused on the team on the pitch, and there's been a real change from last place to you know, near the top of the table, and there's great energy and vibe. And Yael Averbusch, as our GM, has done a great job, and our coach Juan Carlos, and of course our players, are extraordinary. And now we have the chance to do the same on the business side. So some of it's tactical of get a plan that starts the steps and that can lead to the vision that's very much shared across the organization.
So we saw earlier this year a record crowd for the club, more than 15,000. How do you make that a regular occurrence for Gotham?
I think this team should be super proud of that. And I'll tell you, it just has made everybody hungry. I haven't heard, oh, we hit this and it isn't that great. I've heard, you know, that's just the start and let's do more of it. So I do think there were real learnings from that game. The team brought a lot together. A lot was stacked into that game too, right? It was Pride Weekend, which is a very big deal to us. There were great players, including the San Diego team. And our team, I think, is really becoming quite well known. And when our business staff can put a resource and focus around a game, they can really promote the opportunity to come be part of it with us. And the idea is to replicate that and get that to be a general occurrence across our year.
You know, you mentioned the desire to, you know, not only be a beloved team in the New York, New Jersey area, but to grow the brand globally. How do you build a global brand out of Gotham FC? And, you know, there's obviously a few other NWSL clubs that have very public aspirations to, you know, be the global brand in women's soccer as well. So how do you compete with the likes of Angel City, Bay FC, you know, some of the big clubs on the West Coast?
First, I want to say, I already think a superpower of this league is the collaboration among these teams. Like, we can compete fiercely, but everybody wants us to all be incredibly successful. So I do love that. And I've already felt it in very short order. For us, it all starts with fans feeling at home with us, because we are the most diverse multicultural area of the country and one of the most in the entire world. And if people here feel at home with Gotham and feel part of Gotham, that will carry throughout the world. And it's an area that lives large in the imagination of people everywhere. So as we build Gotham authentically here, and it's very much in our neighborhoods, right? From the Jersey Shore to Long Island, to Washington Heights, to Coney Island, that's where we have to live first and foremost. And we will become global quickly. I'll also add, of course, our diverse player group and coach group really helps us immediately be relevant in a very significant way in countries and cities around the world. And so that's a really important part of the equation.
Yeah. And, you know, you mentioned that player group. You guys have, I believe, 6 players on the women's national team. How do you take advantage of that?
Well, I'll tell you, my experience at the New York City Marathon is very helpful here, because what I saw is you can have the biggest name in running. And we had, for example, an unheralded athlete at the time, when Marilson Gomez dos Santos won the marathon, a Brazilian, the response was unlike anything we'd ever seen. And like, that's like tapping into that, getting our athletes in front of communities throughout the area and telling their stories. It's all already there. We have to amplify it and connect to make sure people know. So I think that's already a big opportunity for us.
One of the big things coming up for the league is the new media rights negotiation cycle. I know you're just getting into the new role, but do you have any thoughts on what might be important for the league in order to, you know, grow its popularity to the next level?
I'm sure we're balancing reach and relevance and revenue, right? Those are the factors. I am a big believer and fan of Jessica Berman. I know her well, and know we have an extraordinary leader at the top of this league. And that is, I trust her very much to make great decisions. And we have, starting with our ownership group and Tammy Murphy from the earliest days here, very much committed to this. I think the ownership groups in the NWSL are committed to a long game. And so I'm confident we'll make the really good decisions there. But these are still early days, and there's just massive opportunity right now in front of this league.
Amazing. Well, Mary, congratulations again. And thank you so much for taking the time to join us today.
Thank you. It's my privilege. Look forward to talking to you soon.